Hello friends, in this series of videos in theory of computation, right now we are doing designing of DFA. In the last video we have just designed a DFA starting and ending with A. Now let's go and try some more questions into the same logic. Okay friends, now let's try this question. Again it says what? Design a minimal DFA over alphabet A comma B such that every string accepted must starts and ends with the same symbol. Now you see it's a little bit different thing. It doesn't say you have to start from your end for me. What it says, it starts and ends with the same symbol. So if you starts with A, then you must end with A, and if you start with B, you must end with B. Again, two important point. Is single A and single B acceptable? Certainly yes, because single A also starts with A and ends with A, and single B also starts and ends with the same symbol. Okay, now again you understand, that will be the first question where we actually require more than one final state. You cannot design this machine using only one final state. As far as DFA is concerned, you require two final states, and let me explain why. You understand, here in every question I was saying what you do first thing is, first you design a DFA for the smallest string possible, but here there are two smallest string, one is A and one is what? B. So let me ask you, if I have a straight string, again straight Q naught, if there comes a single A, now let me go to a final state, let me say Q1, and let me say even if B comes, then also I go to what? Final state, and that is the smallest logic possible. But the problem is, if A comes after this Q1, now you tell me, is it valid or invalid on seeing Q1? If you are on a straight Q1 and you have A, is this string valid or invalid? Question is, actually logic is, if you reach Q1 because of A, then this is valid because it's starting and ending with A. But if you reach this Q1, that it is certainly invalid, because if you reach with B, then B after that A, it is invalid. So you understand, if I use same transitions to reach this state either A or B, I get confused while reaching Q1 whether that I have used A or B. So the solution of this problem is, let me use different states. So let me say, if A comes, then I'll go to Q1, and if B comes, then I'll go to what? Q2. But still, both of them should have a final state status. Why? Again you say, because single A and single B both are what? Acceptable. Now that is okay, but now next step is what? You have to complete the logic. Now you understand this thing, Q0 is already being completed, A and B both are there. Now Q0 on A, you go to what? Q1. You tell me, if you are on state Q1, what is the last symbol? Certainly, I'm sure last symbol was A. Now, can there be multiple A's after this? Certainly, yes. A ke ke baad kitna bhi hai, that is not a problem. So let me have a loop on a state Q1. Similarly, you can understand, you can also have a loop on Q2 for B, because if it starts with B, then no matter how many further B comes, you can still be on a final state. But now the question is, if you are on a state Q0, you have A, you go to what? Q1, and if there comes a B on state Q1, now that is certainly not acceptable. Why? If you are on a state Q1, you are on the A side, yes or no? So first symbol was A, then the last symbol should also be what? A. So I must use the same logic which we have used in the previous video. Let me have a new temporary state, and let me name, suppose it is what? Q3, and for some time temporarily, let me go to a state Q3. Yes or no? Yes, because after A, B is not acceptable. Please understand this. Can I use this same transition to reach Q2? Certainly not. Why? Because if you started with A, then after A, B is not acceptable. So I am going to wait here on Q3 temporarily till B comes any number of times. But you understand, that is not a dead state, because if you have started with A, no matter how many B comes, you will loop here. But as soon as A comes, again you will come back to what? Q1. So now you understand, you start with A is acceptable. If B comes, you temporarily go to Q3, you keep looping here, and as soon as A comes, you come back to what? Q1. Now that is a perfect logic. And same analogous to that, if B comes, I'll loop on a final state. But if A comes, now that is not acceptable. Why? Because if you started with B, then you have to end up with what? B. If A comes, I'll loop here temporarily for A, but as soon as B come, let me come back to what? Again Q2. So now you understand, it is very simple but first kind of a machine where you require actually two final states, you see. So this is a party for what? A, and this is a party for what? B. So now that is a DFA which accepts what? All the strings which starts and ends with the same symbol. Okay friends, now let's try one more question, but this time just a little difference. You must start and ends with the different symbol. And now that is very good case, you so you understand. If you start with A, then you must end with what? B. And if you start with B, then you must end with what? A. But again you understand, can I see here also single A and single B acceptable? Now this time not, because if it is a single symbol, then you cannot start and end with the same symbol, with a different symbol. So single A or single B is not acceptable. But what is the framework? A, then you end with what? B. If you start with B, then you end with what? A. Now you tell me again, what is the two simplest string possible? Certainly from this you can have what? AB. And from this you can have what? BA. So again let me do that. And again, like the previous case, still in this case also we require two final states. More or less the framework will be same. So again, let me remember what comes. If A comes, I'll go to Q1. And if B comes, I'll go to Q2. And that is certainly acceptable. Because if A, after which B comes, then that is what? Acceptable. And again, let me say, if B comes, let me go to what? Q3. And if after that A comes, let me go to what? Q4. And that is also what? Acceptable. So A ke baad B and B ke baad A, certainly these two cases are what? Acceptable. Now you understand this thing. Next logic is to complete the system. Okay, Q0 is already completed. Now let's concentrate on Q1. You see, if B comes, I'll go to final state. If A comes, what should I do? I must loop on the state Q1. Why? Because what we require is that A in the last, you must have what? B. But if there comes any number of A, no problem on that. I can wait and keep looping on what? Q1 till you don't give me a B. If you already have B and further you have any number of B, that is also not a problem. I can still wait on the final state. Because you started with A, then you can loop on what? B. But now you understand, if A comes, again I have to come back this non-final state temporarily. Because in this case you have started with A, so you must end up on what? B. Again, if A comes, then temporarily I'll come back to Q1, wait here till the B comes, and if B comes again, that will be what? Acceptable. The same analogous logic here. So Q0, you start with B, you end with A. If there comes further A, no problem at all. Even if after single B, no matter how many B comes, I'll wait here. But after reaching a final state, again if B comes, then I have to come back to what? This non-final state, then only it is what? Acceptable. Please understand one more thing. How you understand that it requires more than one final state? You see, when there's a loop on final state, we'll solve some more questions where you'll find if there's a self loop or final states. Now you can just combine them. Here I cannot combine those final states because you see their behavior are exactly different. It supports B, but it do not supports A as A go backs. But this final state supports A, but it do not supports what? B. If I just combine them, the total system will get confused because you will not remember whether on A you should loop or on B you should loop, on what symbol you should go back. So that will be the final optimal machine. And again, with five states and two final states, now this machine is certainly doing what? It will accept all the strings which starts and ends with the same symbol. Okay, thank you.